Odums back on the Boss Man Show with Dawson Odums, the coach of Norfolk State Spartans out of the MEAC Conference. Coach, how you doing today, sir?
Doing outstanding. Doing outstanding again. Thank you for having me on. Always a pleasure to talk about the program.
Yes, sir. Coach, tell me this, man. You took this job this spring here, moved on from down there where you were at Southern. Now you're at Norfolk State. Tell us about this opportunity. What stood out about it, and why did you want to become a Spartan now?
Well, I just think it's all about time, and it's all about being around the right people at the right time. Dr. Adams Gaston, our president of this great university here at Norfolk State, has us going in the right direction, and it's just great to see the growth. It's a student-centered university. The students are first a priority, and they're very important, and that's something that I think should always be at the helm and at the forefront when you talk about universities. And then you look at our AD. She's coming in her first year as well, and just trying to make sure that she has her legacy and leave a legacy to be known to all those that follow her. And just being in at the front end and just being close to the family and friends and just having the opportunity to start something new. I just thought it was the right time. And it's a program that was looking for a new injection, some new belief and a new process. And I felt like it would fit well with me and the staff that we put together and just try to get these young men going in the right direction. And so far, so good.
Tell us about that part, Coach. Knowing you're a new coach, man, you know, guys don't really know you have to build a relationship with those young men. How's that been for you and your staff from the spring until now?
Well, I just think when you, first of all, let them know you love them and you care about them, everything else has a chance to fall in place. And that's being in my process. That's being in how we do things is that I understand I came through the HBCU ranks coming out of North Carolina Central. You have a better understanding of what it is that young men really need in life. I grew up from the time I was 9. I didn't have a father. So a lot of my coaches played an important role in my life. And I try to play an important role in the young man's life that are under my tutelage. I think I'm good at being a mentor. I think it's great to be a father to these guys and you put your arm around them and you want the best success for them. But they have to understand they got to do that with great discipline and just follow the process in place. And we do a great job of teaching our process and getting young men to buy in.
And Coach, it's funny you mentioned that, Coach. You know, I'm the same way. One for football, I won't be on here on this lounge today because without coaches who inspired me as a young man growing up in Atlanta, I would never have been where I am today. So like you said, having those coaches in your life to propel you and motivate you and mentor you and guide you can make a difference in guys like yourselves' lives and my lives as well for us to be what we're doing, what we love to do now and doing it at a high level.
Well, you're right. And I think that's the biggest thing is just making sure that you trust your process, that this is a multi-million dollar company that we represent in college athletics and football. You have to understand that you're a CEO and that you have to operate like you're a CEO. And I tell these guys that are under us, you have to operate like businessmen that you are. You're great. I tell them all the time how great they are. I tell them all the time how wonderful they are. And they're not wonderful because they're playing at Norfolk State. They're wonderful because their parents have given them some great gifts. And we're trying to help you at Norfolk State to allow your tool belt to expand so that you can reach the success that's in store for you.
And Coach, talk about this, man. You know, young men's growth and development and mental health now is very much more in the forefront than what the Olympics passing here with Naomi Osaka, other athletes talking about mental health. How have your staff and your university kind of worked to make sure your young men have an outlet for mental health so they can always have an outlet to help them, whether it be stuff with classes, stuff on the field, or something on their personal lives? How have y'all done that to help foster for your young men in that environment there?
Well, for one, we talk about it daily. Mindset is something that we focus on. I just don't think you can change who you are or change your direction or change yourself or change the outcome of your family without understanding that you got to first change your mindset. And that's big in our program. We talk about the mental part of our program so much. I'm always doing things to challenge these guys mentally because if we cannot change you mentally, then your decision-making process will be what it is. We have to first think, not only first, but we have to think about what we're thinking to be able to say that we want to make better decisions and better choices. And that's what it's all about, is getting these young men to understand that nobody's against you. More people will be for you based on the decisions that you make. And just working on our positive mindset is just staying positive regardless of what the world say about you. regardless of what you're going through in life, find the positives and point out those positives. Yeah, life is going to create some things that we cannot control, but let's focus on the things that we can control. And you in full control of whether or not you wake up in the day and have a positive attitude. And I always tell them the only difference between the good day and the bad day is your attitude. So we work on pouring into them from a positivity standpoint. We work on just making sure we build relationships so we have a good understanding of what these guys are dealing with in life. We don't understand sometimes what they're going through, so we give them a platform to express themselves. And I really think that's big. We're a coach's program, a coach me coach type program. And I really believe in being in these guys' lives and really getting a chance to understand them from a mental standpoint.
And coach, talk about this as well, coach. You know, strength and conditioning is very important for young men. Tell us how important it is for their rest and their recovery and nutrition as they want them to play fast on Saturdays for you guys, and how teaching them about how putting the right fuel in their bodies and help them be better come Saturday afternoons or Saturday nights.
Well, it's very important. I think that's some of the things that we lack at HBCUs is really catching up to that part of it. I think the mental part of the game is very important. And I think the nutritional part of the game is very important. And I told my guys, I said, we're going to build a field house in the end zone. And that field house is going to be equipped with a training table, and it's going to have the proper nutrition that you guys deserve. And we're going to make sure that we're going to have a D1 atmosphere, even though we may play FCS football. And they just look at me. I said, but I'm not asking you to believe in my vision. I wouldn't be here if I didn't have big dreams. But I believe those things can happen, and they will happen. We just have to do our part. But it's like you asked, it is very important that hydration and recovery, eating right, and just having those things to be able to do that. And I think that's important. And I think as we continue to grow this program, I really think that big vision that I have for it is going to manifest. And I'm going to keep believing and keep working towards it because, again, it's about the young man in the program. It's about our student athletes here at Norfolk State. And we want to give them the best experience. And we also want to give them a chance to say that, you know what, we might not be in D1, but Norfolk State showed treat us like we were.
No doubt. And coach, I went to Tennessee State, so I know firsthand about how HBCUs are and the resources and what they were, what the per diem was back in 05 when I was at Tennessee State. So I know exactly what you mean. And you've been in Clark Atlanta right down the road from where I grew up at. So I know you know as well, being in Central. So yeah, I mean, like you said, the resources at HBCU level has always been the issue because we need a little bit more help. But like you said, having that vision and having that belief, it'll happen. And I feel like more and more HBCU has been more and more in vogue after what happened to George Floyd. More and more has come in to help our schools get more to help our young men, help our players be even better and show them that they are D1 as well, though we're playing FCS ball.
Well, exactly. I think some of the issues related to life has brought a lot of notoriety and national attention to us as a whole. I think we have to understand what role we play in that and how we must get our mindset to a place to where we can understand that we have a chance to make this world better. And that's all I talk about with our players, is that you come to college to get a degree, and that degree is your ticket to life. That ticket to life is to set you up from take you from hourly employee to a salary employee, take you from renting to buying, take you from poor decisions to great decisions. And that's what going to college is all about. Those are the years where you find yourself. And at the end of the line, you hope to get a degree that puts you at the front of the line, and just teaching you how to sell yourself, because no degree is worth anything without your name on it. And just getting these guys to understand that and believe in that. And I think when you look at what we're doing as an institution with great academics here at Norfolk State University, we have a beautiful campus. We have a good enrollment class coming in with freshmen this year. I think right now is the time. And I think that's one of the reasons I chose to come here, is because you can sense that something great was taking place in Norfolk, Virginia.
And coach, you have a great schedule non-conference wise before getting the MEAC play. You got Toledo, Wake Forest, Elizabeth City State, St. Francis, Hampton up the road from me in Virginia, Lynchburg. Tell us about that schedule, how it's going to challenge your young men out the gates for you getting that MEAC play.
It's tough in the beginning. We're playing the FBS opponents and group of six, and we'll have our work cut out for us. We're on the road for two straight games. But I really think it's good. I think you want to give your guys a platform to be able to showcase their talents. And why not Norfolk State? And my thing to them is that we go get a chance to play. I said, if you see two footballs out there, we got problems. If you see 13 people on the field at one time, we probably got a problem, because they should only have 11 and it should only be one football. But if they playing with 11 and they got one football, remember, man, they put their pants on the same way you do. You got to always understand that you don't play the uniform, play the man that's behind the face mask. And let's get our mindset to where it needs to be able to compete at a high level. And we'll break the game down into parts and just say, okay, where are we at after part one? Where are we at after part two? And hopefully we can get in a position where we have an opportunity to win a football game. I think we're going to go in with great spirits. I think we're going to go in believing, and I think we're going to go in with a good football team. Hey, the ball may not bounce our way. Some things may happen that we had no control over. But at the end of the day, if we do the necessary things and prepare ourselves the right way, I think this is a good football team. We ought to give ourselves a chance to have some success at the start. Then we get in that non-conference schedule. We continue with it, you know, after we come back out the Wake Forest and get our home opener. Anything shy of 30,000 is going to be very disappointing. We haven't played football here at Norfolk State in almost 2 years. So if we can't get 30,000 people to come watch us play our season opener out the layoff, then football must not be that important. And I really believe that. We open up with Elizabeth City. We got four home games. We understand the magnitude of those games, and we need our fans to play a part in the atmosphere and creating an atmosphere that's electric so that people who see it on TV say, you know what, I want to go to Norfolk State. They don't understand that everything that we do is about branding this great university, yes, showcasing the world that we are not somebody to be second. We're a first class, we're a first class organization. We got first class leaders, and we need our first class fans to show up and show out and make a lot of noise in supporting the Spartans.
Oh, that's what it coach, recruiting-wise, with this transfer portal, I feel like it's going to help you all get talented players who want an opportunity to play. You know, I feel like it's going to help you guys out a lot, you know, because like I said, you have a great pedigree yourself, and, you know, playing for somebody like yourself, I feel like a young man want to come play for you, Norfolk State, where they may went to Virginia Tech, and didn't get the playing time they want to, but come to you and get a chance to show their skills, because the eye of the sky does not lie. That if you can play, they'll find you.
I agree with you 100%, and we got a great venue. We got a great atmosphere. We got a great fan base. Our alumni is outstanding. This university is located in the area of Virginia where you can get to the beach, you can get downtown. It's seven cities that surround it. It's a great opportunity for a young man to not only play football, but grow as a young man. And that, to me, is important. And I think we have a support system here at Norfolk State to help you go from a freshman to a degree and from help you go from a freshman football player to the NFL. We got players that have come out of here that have been really good, that have played at the next level. And my question to you is, why not you? This is a great opportunity, a great time to be a Spartan, and Norfolk State University is about to rise up. So come and be a part of the new resurrection of the Spartans. We're about to take off. And as I always say, Spartans are coming.
Last one for you, Coach. Just go back to today's here in Atlanta, Coach. What's your favorite spot to eat here in ATL when you're in town, man?
Man, you know, the wings, man. I have to find me a good wing place. Atlanta Wings is a good one. Just the chicken wings in Atlanta are so good. There's so many great places to eat, especially when it comes to wings. And that's probably one of my first things to do is find me some good old-fashioned fried chicken wings.
I hear that, Coach. Thank you for your time today, and I look forward to cheering for you guys, Spartan up for sure, Coach. And I'll be cheering for this game, which get with you real soon, Coach.
Always a pleasure. Thank you. Behold the green and gold.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, Coach.
Appreciate you.
All right, now.